We're back. This summer, Kate's sister, Jody, and her husband went public with allegations that your kids were being exploited and overworked. In comments to Radar Online, you denounced their criticism as ridiculous. Watch.
The kids look like they're having a good time. They're having a great time. And, I mean, honestly, we film like an hour and a half, 2 hours on camera. They love the camera crew. They love all those guys. They make nicknames for them. You know, the PAs, the production assistants there, they play with the kids. We all get along and play together. And it's like a family environment.
You sorry you said that?
Yeah, I'm sorry I said that. You know, and I do...
But you meant it, didn't you?
Correct. And I can make mistakes as well. And, you know, I do regret it, but I talked to Jody today, and...
Your sister-in-law.
Yeah, Kate's sister-in-law. Mm. And, you know, if I would have said opposite of that, if I would have said TLC is exploiting the kids, or we are, I'm breach of contract. So, either
way... But you weren't lying. I mean, you meant it,
No, I meant it. And I felt that way. And now, looking back, and what has recently happened after filing for doors, I mean, this has been a media explosion. This is ridiculous. I've been on the cover of magazines since January. You know, and it's just crazy. I want the father to stop, and I want Kate and I to mediate. I want us to become friends. I want us to figure out our marriage, and I don't want it to be filmed anymore. And I don't want the kids involved, and I just feel it's unfair.
How well did you get along with the people at TLC?
I don't get along with the people at TLC. Not all along. Since January, I started getting calls from the executives. And? Which is so rare. You really don't really hear from them.
What were they saying?
Basically that I'm in breach of contract and, you know, I can't go out. They put me on house arrest. They gave me a bodyguard for 3 weeks.
House arrest?
Yeah, it's house arrest. I had 24/7 bodyguards.
Are you saying, Mark, that this contract's null? Are you saying this isn't a contract?
This is a null contract for the following reason. As mentioned earlier, at the time that these two struggling people were desperate for money, TLC came with a cadre of lawyers, the most sophisticated contract you've ever seen, and said sign. He had no manager. He had no lawyer. He had no idea of what he was signing. What's more upsetting is the contract provided that there was no compensation specifically for the kids. These kids have been working for the past 4 years without any specified contract being attributed to them.
Wouldn't it be in violation of child labor law to have a contract with a kid?
That's precisely so. And the investigation has been undertaken by the Labor Department, which may expose the respective parties to almost $2 million of fines because they require a permit. TLC, contrary to what was represented to John, never got a permit for the kids to act, never got a permit for the location. And these provisions render it as against public policy.
But you didn't bring that up while he was gainfully happy there.
I was not his attorney, and that's why this has all come about now in the last few weeks.
This is from TLC. They say there is no legal or factual justification for asserting that the agreement with TLC may be null and void. TLC has no doubt that its agreement with the Gosselin family is legally enforceable. Are you saying here now that you are going to court? Are you suing them? Are you going to court to say this is null and void? What's your next action?
Not only will we be going to the state court, but being on this program before you and your viewers, we're in court. We're in the court of public opinion. And I defy TLC to satisfy you and your viewers that they are right and John is wrong. This contract is void. And this contract is detrimental.
Concerning
this man's family.
Concerning the compensation for the children, we also have a response on that. You claim they failed to designate appropriate compensation for the children. Here's what TLC says. Contractually, the matter of designating specific compensation for children is the responsibility of John and Kate. However, TLC has actively and regularly encouraged the parents to establish compensation, trust arrangements for the children. Our understanding is that Kate has set up a trust for the benefit of the children with a substantial portion of the income from the show. Doesn't that answer it?
No. The Labor Department will give the real answer, not the spin that TLC wants. The Labor Department is going to say, where's the permit? Where's the money? How many hours have they worked? What have you paid?
John, while you were doing this show, for how many years now?
4.
Did you ever think to yourself, I need some permission from the state or some permit for these kids to be on television?
I was unaware of even requiring for a permit. I thought that was up to the production company. The only time I ever realized it was when the Labor Department contacted our attorneys and said, hey, you don't have a permit to film.
Did TLC ask you to set up a trust for the children?
No.
We'll be back with more of John Gosselin, Mark J. Heller on this edition of Larry King Live, back in 60 seconds. We're back, by the way, Mark, with respect to the permits, location permits. TLC says location permits are not required for documentary filming.
This is a staged proceedings. They're under direction, and this is their argument, but clearly this is production. Remember, TLC made $186 million, rumor has it, for the quarter, as attributable to the John and Kate show. And they've really become a monster in John's mind. And John's not going to let this monster swallow up his family.
But you made a lot of money, didn't you, John? Frankly?
No.
Not?
No.
What'd you make last year?
What I make total, including the show?
No, just the show.
Just the show? Maybe $1 million.
Compared to profit?
After taxes is $500,000 divided by 10.
And Kate also made $1 million?
No.
Million, both of you?
The agreement is the Gosselin family. It's not broken out. That's what we made. $22.5 per episode.
And you're saying not fair in relation to the profits.
They made $186 million, and that money isn't allocated. The Labor Department may come along and say, you know what? You never paid the kids anything. It's John, one unit, Kate, and they may take a third, and we may say, you know what? They're going to split that $1 million, and you give another $500,000 to the kids.
You're giving that up, though, now, John. I mean, they could have had to pay you, maybe, under this contract,
Yeah, I'm giving it up because I need to be a father. I need to be a father, and I need to take my kids off the show. And, my kids have voiced their opinions, too. I was on a shoot a couple months ago. It was 96 degrees outside. We were shooting outside with the kids. It was my custody day, my shoot. My kids went inside the house, put their bathing suits on, and jumped in the pool. Shoot over. What am I supposed to do? I went down the pool and I watched them. I said, I can't do anything about it.
We have a tweeter question, tweeted via King's Things, our Twitter spot. When they get older, how will you explain to your kids your decision to let them be on TV in the first place?
I've thought about this numerous times. I mean, there's two ways it could go. They could either say, hey, you know, we had a great opportunity, we traveled a lot, we did a lot of things. Or they can say, why did you expose our lives to this? Or why did you do this? And that's the one that's sticking in my head. That's the one I'm thinking, well, you know what? They're 5 and 8 now. Let's get them off TV. Let's let them experience a normal childhood.
Are you feeling guilt?
Absolutely.
What is Kate feeling?
I can't speak for Kate.
When was the last time you spoke to her?
3.5 weeks ago.
Did she mention anything about any of this?
No, she wants to continue with the show to financially benefit maybe herself and the kids.
More after this. Don't go away.